In today's episode, I'm going to be showing you two universal masalas. One is Kitchen King masala, which is used in a lot of dry sabzis as well as gravies. The other one is Pulao masala that can be used in various rice dishes. So let's see the recipe. So first, I'm going to start with making the Kitchen King masala, for which I'm going to roast a few ingredients. I have here 2 tablespoons of coriander seeds, 1 tablespoon of cumin seeds, 15 to 18 whole peppercorns, 10 to 12 cloves, 2 black cardamoms, 1 star anise, 1 inch piece cinnamon, 1 teaspoon fenugreek seeds, 1 mace, 1 very small piece of nutmeg, 1 tablespoon yellow mustard seeds, 1 tablespoon poppy seeds, 1 tablespoon fennel seeds or sauf, 2 bay leaves, 4 spicy dry chilies, 4 Kashmiri chilies. All the whole spices are in the pan. Now let's turn the flame on. Roast these spices on medium flame for around 2 minutes. This helps in bringing out the natural oils of the spices. Also, it toasts them up so that it's easier to grind the powder. The spices are done. Let's remove it in a plate and let it cool down completely. Make sure that you do not let it cool in a pan. I'm going to be adding 1 fresh ingredient, that is about 10 to 15 curry leaves. Now curry leaves, you can dry roast them in a pan. Make sure you do not roast them with the whole spices, do it separately. Or I prefer roasting them in the microwave, because in 30-40 seconds they crisp up beautifully. So let's microwave them. The curry leaves are beautifully crisped up and now it's time to grind all the ingredients. Add the curry leaves in the grinder. Remove the seeds of the black cardamom. Now add in a few dry powders, 1 tablespoon of dry ginger powder, 1 tablespoon of onion powder, 1 tablespoon of garlic powder, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1/4 teaspoon of white salt. Grind all these ingredients into a fine powder. I'm going to remove it in a bowl. The Kitchen King masala is ready. Let's keep it aside. All my ingredients for the next recipe, which is Pulao masala, are here. So let's start roasting them. 2 tablespoons of coriander seeds, 1.5 tablespoons of cumin seeds, 20 cloves, 1 inch piece cinnamon, 15 black pepper, 1 tablespoon white peppercorns, 10 to 12 green cardamom, 1 tablespoon fennel seeds, 2 mace, 2 bay leaves. Turn on the flame. Toss all these ingredients and roast them for around 2 minutes. This masala comes quite handy in making many rice varieties like paneer pulao, mixed vegetable pulao, or aloo pulao. So it's a good masala to have in your kitchen. Keep stirring. Get it off the flame and cool it down in a plate. The spices have cooled down completely. Let's remove the cardamom seeds from the pods and add it in the grinder. Let's add in the remaining spices. Add in 1/4 teaspoon salt and grind all these ingredients into a fine powder. I'm going to remove it in a bowl.
These masalas can be stored in an airtight container at room temperature for a couple of months. In case you want to store them for a longer period of time, you can refrigerate them. This spice blend is definitely infused with spices that is going to bring a traditional taste to your table. So do try this recipe, comment below, subscribe to Rajshree Food. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.